is the very essence of African life. In Uruwa, we have no pain. There's no anger. In Uruwa, we forgive because we want to be forgiven. I do not come to say things to you that I need to be forgiven, because everything I deploy, I want it to be true, and it will be true, because that's the only thing I can wish I travel. I didn't have to travel on another. It's going to be true. This is it. So what did I find? That we black people were the one that Hippocrates traveled, and when he went to Africa, he noticed that there were no hospitals, there were no doctors, there were no medicine. And these black folks was jumping and hanging on trees, living up to 300 years. What's going on there? The tree scores of 10 was out the window. We lived 3 times that. But somebody in Europe said that we were supposed to live 3 scores of 10, whatever number that is, I don't know. But she didn't tell us these things. And we have to believe them. So tonight, what we were told was not the truth. It was far from the truth. But look how strong our biology is, that we live at least 80 years. I'll be 80 next year. I'm 79 now, yes. But what does that mean? My friend uncle just married a woman 17, and she's pregnant, and he's 117. You see? You see the noise you just made? You just made that noise because we cannot fathom. How could that be possible that a man 117 years of age is going to impregnate a 17 year old wife? Well, it is possible. But you and I would never fathom that. We would never be able to process that well, because you and I have been eating starch and blood 500 years. And if we take the starch and blood to the blackboard, well, we're going to ask some questions tonight. Why am I supposed to eat this blood? Well, Dr. Sebi, after all, you need your protein. Protein. What is that? I know that's a word that's supposed to be associated with food and nutrition, all right? But what is it? What is protein? Is it meat? That's where you find the highest concentration of protein, in meat. So I'm supposed to eat meat to get protein. Okay, fine. What is protein that I need it so much? Is it electrical? The doctor looked at me, Dr. Steinberg. This is a woman that was head of the pediatric hospital in Washington, D.C. She was treating a little girl named Akila Stroud. So they took her out of the hospital, brought her to me. I took everything away from Akila that constituted protein. They took me by the police back to the hospital 90 days later. But the child no longer had sickle cell anemia. But the doctor's talking about protein. So this is one of the edifices that they put, that they have constructed, that you and I know nothing about. And we believe it. But if I ask any one of you in the audience, what is protein? You don't know. I don't know. I'm not ashamed to say, I don't know. So when I ask Dr. Sadler, what is protein? She can give you a response that is generally given when asked about the substance. Protein is one of the 19 amino acids, the building blocks of life. Amino acids. What does amino acids have to do with my life and my biology when the body is composed of minerals? So now, what is the difference with Dr. Sebi and the rest of the compound that you guys have been hearing about? People have been saying about the impure, this, that, and the other. Well, of course, I like to hear that. meeting the last time I was in here in the Bahamas. I said to her, I was admiring her dress that she was wearing. Many of you was at that meeting. Admire her dress. But I was looking at this lady and listening to her story, how the doctors ate up her money. You see? They ate up her money. I am her brother. I'm of the same gene. Do you think that it would be good if I were to have eaten up her money likewise and not give her what she needed? No. No, it's about love. I told her, I'm going to try to help you, young lady. And there she is now. She wrote me a love letter. I want to read it. I haven't read it yet. I don't think Jamal has the letter. But these are the things that we need to practice among ourselves, not only from a healer or a servant to you. Each and every one of us, we are supposed to exhibit that. And if we are not, that tells us how sick we are. I can't love my neighbor. No way. I can't love Chinese. Why, he's a Chinaman. I don't know him. Yeah, but why should I hold my love? Because when you give it, it's when you feel good, right? When you give love, you feel good that you have it to give. Of course you do. So what's the difference? Dr. Sebi went to the forest and began selecting the herbs that God made from the herb that man made. And how do we find the difference? I said pH test. But once upon a time, we African people, we didn't need to know anything about pH. Why? Because everything that we had in the environment in Africa was alkaline. It was nothing but acid. Now, everything we eat is acid. Please don't go to Africa. Don't go to Africa and see what they eat, because you're going to get scared. I mean, I've been in one country, Nigeria. You got on one side, the north is the Hausa. In the west, you have the Igbo, and the south, the Igbo and the west is the Yoruba. Now, if you look at what they eat every day, they call it gari. Gari is a starch. It's a compound starch that has cyanide. Here is a man eating cyanide with blood. With blood. And then you think that this man is capable of sitting and solving a problem with love? No. He's eating blood like an animal that eats blood. That's how he's going to behave. So what happened in the 80s? Was it in the 80s or the 70s? It was in the late 60s. The Biafran War. Nigerians killing Nigerians. How does that help? Doesn't help. Somebody's angry. Somebody is angry. All of us are angry. And I'm one of them. I'm not as bad as you would like to think. I would hope that I am, but look at what I have to go through. 30 years of eating pig feet, pork chops, rice and beans, oatmeal, cornflakes with cow milk in it. The boy was insane. But it took a certain degree of obedience for me to submit to the Mexican. The Mexican said, you are full of shit. I said, you're crazy. You say, I may be, but you are full of shit. My belly was out here. It was 42. The brother was sick. But I went to the black doctors, the healers, the herbalists. I went to Chinese. They didn't heal me. Somebody called and said, you better go to Puerto Rico, Mexico. I speak Spanish. Born in Honduras. Spanish country. I went to the man put me in a diet, he put me in his herbs, and here I am 49 years later, talking to you about the same healing. is he going to do that? What premise? What foundation? What arrangement? Well, guess what I did? Being a steam engineer, I would begin to experiment with these plants and give them to people. And give them to people. Give them away because I had a good job. They would come back and say, you know, Dr. Sebi, when I eat a soup, I raise up my head too fast, I get dizzy. And I know you guys are experiencing that. So, the other one would say, you know the stuff that you gave me? It stopped the dizziness, but I'm weak. Then I put another compound together. Then the other one would say, well, you know, I haven't been to the bathroom. I've made something to the bathroom. So as they begin to tell me about the maladies, I begin to record that. Then I begin to ask you, sir?
Yes.
Do you get this when you school sometimes?
Oh, yes. How do you know?
But I was so about that before. Ladies, after that 50, what part of you hurts?
Oh, God, my arm.
This and that. And anyway, I'm in menopause. I said, that's okay. Menopause is false too. What you mean by that? Well, let me see. There was a woman in New York that went into menopause when she was 42. And when she came to me, she's 51. But she came to me because she had five fibroid tumors. They came out. I mean, she tried to warn me. I thought I was a phone call. Nigga, if I get pregnant, the baby's yours. She got pregnant and had a baby at 52. Little baby named Makita. The beautiful little girl. So we are not going to think tonight that what is said is true. And that when you get sick, that's the end of it. No. It could just very well be the beginning of your life. Because now you're going to put forth effort into reversing that. So Dr. Sebi went and he selected from the plants of the world only the plants that are alkaline, the plants that are natural, the plants that are electrical. Name some of them. Guaco, Contrivo, Hombre Grande, Calawala, San Sarsaparilla. In Africa, you have the Maruna, you have the Cantanza, you have the Sia, you have the Popa, and you have the other one, the Hulia. These are electric plants. They will heal. So what do we do? What I do is to cleanse the body. While as an engineer, I put together a cleansing. Cleansing, an intracellular chelation. We're going to clean every cell that makes up every organ that totals the biological you. I can't miss. Because my computation, my sight, my vision says there is only one disease. There never been two. Greg will say, "Man, you out of your mind. They're gonna ridicule you, boy." I said, "Greg, look, man. When someone has sinusitis, what's in the nasal passage?" He said, "Mucus." "And when someone has bronchitis, what's in the bronchial tube?" He said, "Mucus." "And when you have glaucoma, what's in the eye?" "Mucus again." "And when you're insane, where is the mucus?" We were always able to reduce things to the least common denominator. That's us black people. We made it easy. So while Hippocrates establishing the principle of medical science, I asked the judge in New York, "Your Honor, I am before the Supreme Court today because I have been practicing medicine without a license. And I claim to cure AIDS. Selling products not approved by the FDA. Your Honor, I knows nothing about jurisprudence. I knows nothing about the law.
I know nothing at all, period, really. I'm glad that the good Lord has placed in my hands the understanding of helping you deserve. But you know, in my state of ignorance, I'm going to ask three questions to the physicians. And my whole case would rest on these three questions. What are the questions? Your Honor, is it a fact that the Holy Bible teaches that the herbs are for the healing of the nations? Said yes. Is it a fact that the father of medicine cured every disease using herbs? He said yes. Establishing the principle of medical science? Yes. He did not use any chemicals. I'm using her, but I'm being prosecuted. I would like for you to explain this to me, Your Honor. I am the one that's following the Bible, and the problem is I'm science. Because science shows that the human body is carbon-based, and that the only substance that will complement a carbon-based body is a carbon-based substance. And do you know that the only substance on this planet that is carbon-based are those that are made by God? If you burn a carrot, it doesn't burn to carbon. It doesn't have it, because it's a laboratory product.
Your Honor,
is it a fact that science shows that we are electrical?
Yes.
Being that we are electrical, shouldn't it be that our compound should be electrical?
Said yes.
But the FDA doesn't want me to distribute my product. I would like the FDA to explain to the courts today, when they remove the black man from Africa, did they bring his food with him? The FDA could not utter a word. There again, we are afraid to talk, even when we are entertaining something that is in our favor. I am not owned by any nations of the world. I'm not the property of anyone. I'm the son of God Almighty. Nobody owned me.
So,
on that premise, we have the right to question everything. Everything. So, yes, Uruwa
helped me tremendously to understand that even though I am not a Muslim, I am not a Christian, I'm not a Buddha, I'm not a Hindu, but my obligation is to love everybody just the same as I love myself. That is important. Now, where we begin to see the difficulty in doing so is that we get nervous. Then we take our time and go to the physician looking for help because that's all we know. But he's unable to help us because his premise is not really right too tight. And I don't believe that the physician knows that himself, because the physicians could do a better job than me. He could diagnose you on things that I cannot see. But I don't need his diagnostic procedures. I could look at you and tell what's wrong. I wouldn't have done anything. And a policeman came to me and said that he had a friend that was sick. But you said that you don't need to know what he has. I said, no, I don't need to know. What did I put together? An intracellular chelation. I'm going to clean every cell that makes up every organ that totals you. The man took the remedy, he took the remedy, he took the remedy about 4 or 5 times. But in one of those intervals, Mary Regina Charles, who was the Prime Minister of America, kicked me out. You are leaving, you are gone, bye, with your herbal compound. I said, but Miss Charles, am I not in compliance with God Almighty? Of course I am. Of course I am. Why are you kicking me out?
Not that I'm feeling any way because you're kicking me out, but give me a reason.
Well, Dominica only supports the practice of Orthodox medicine.
I say Orthodox medicine.
What makes it Orthodox? Something that has been established and followed.
Well, hypocrisy started the principle by using herbs, and I'm doing that.
Who is in compliance?
You gotta leave anyway.
I said, thank you.
So yes, I put compounds together that addresses the colon.
Why the colon?
Because the colon is that organ that is responsible for every manifestation of disease. Colon.
When this colon is obstructed and is full of debris, it sends out these negative messages. It may be insanity, it may be diabetes, maybe impotence, but it's going to be something negative. So we cleanse the colon. After cleaning the colon, we know that the nerves have been jarred.
I was so nervous, I was placed in a psychiatric ward in New Jersey in 1961.
The boy wanted to kill his wife. She never knew it. She didn't know it until one day I took my present wife to her.
Marilyn didn't know I wanted to kill her.
Why did I want to kill Marilyn?
Because my body was that sick.
So ladies and gentlemen, after cleansing the colon and treating the nerve, now we have another step to make. The blood.
The blood has to be strengthened and revitalized, but we have to cleanse the blood. Because the blood has been picking up bacteria from what you eat.
Oils, spices, all kinds of meats, all these things are shock. Then it begins to distribute to make the blood heavy. Then we have to clean the blood. We have to clean it. Because you have overworked the white corpuscles. The white corpuscles want to remove debris from the blood, but instead of removing the debris, it eats up the whole cell sometimes. And that's where anemia sets in, or leukemia. Notice carefully that most of us at my age, they find themselves with kidney problems or leukemia. Because over the years, we've been eating the things that will undermine the iron cells in the body. We've been eating things that makes us angry, that makes us feel bad in our own self, not to mention the neighbor. I mean, with yourself, sometimes you lay in bed. Sometimes we lay in bed
and we begin to think. And what we think brings tears to our eyes and we don't know how to control it.
You see, all these things are settled. So when I came to the Bahamas, I told my friend, Jamal, I hope that my compounds would not undermine me in the Bahamas. He said, why? I said, because the love that I feel in the Bahamas, the people in the Bahamas have shown so much of it that I would like for them to think that I'm coming with some kind of hocus pocus. And I was a recipient of hocus pocus. I was a recipient of voodoo. They gave me their little bones and stuff. Didn't have me, so I hope that when I come to the Bahamas, that this compound would not fail me.
But when Jamal told me that someone was cured of diabetes,
yes,
and that somebody PSA was 49 and it was down to 0.3, yes, when I begin to think, because of that, I told him, I said, you know, I have been around the world, Caribbean, Africa, South and Central America, because I speak Spanish.
and the way I feel about the Bahamas, I said it would be nice if we develop the Center of Endocrinology in the Bahamas. Julian, we have Mikey, we have Jamal and myself, five brothers.
Yes.
We are going to develop this center here in the Bahamas, not only to address you, it is to address the world. Nothing extraordinary. He's a brother just like you. There is no brother in this audience that I'm better than. There is no brother in this audience that I'm lesser than. I am your brother standing here, no better, no worse. With the hope that what he brings will be shared among us. Because my intent upon seeing your response is that we could very well be the first nation of organic medicine right here in the Bahamas. When the people in the country where I was born, Honduras, saw the speech that I gave the last time I was here and the attendance, they were embarrassed. Well, in Africa, well, about 10 people there. Well, in our hometown, about 12. In America, a few hundreds. But in the Bahamas, you all come by the thousands.
Yeah.
That says something about you. Feeling this way, naturally, I feel like a Bahamian. I never felt attached to any country like I feel attached to the Bahamas. Because in the country where I was born, they don't treat me this way. Because it's a country that has a different mandate. It is Latin, Hispanic, and I expect that. They don't understand what I come with, most of them, and I understand that too. Not that they're bad, no they're not. Hispanic people are just as good as you and me. In fact, if it wasn't for a Hispanic, I wouldn't be standing here alive today. Alfredo Cortez, the Mexican that healed me when I needed help. So you see, we all are interrelated. Like I need a white man need the Mexican, you need the Chinese, and we all need each other. And if we cooperate, we will begin to see the beauty in each and every one of us. Because there is beauty in everybody and everyone. What happened? We've been made sick. I'm going to use an example. A little girl in Puerto Rico, her name is Antonina. I used to go under the mango trees because they had people sick there. And this girl would always sit on the sidewalk and she would snort cocaine. And she asked me for $5. I gave her the $5 and she went and bought cocaine. She went and bought cocaine the second day. She asked me for $5 again on Wednesday. She bought cocaine. On the third day, she said, "What do you want with me?" I said, "I may want all of you." She held that. I said, "Because God made you just as good as the Queen of England. The Queen of England is married to you. Because God just doesn't do that. But yet, you elect to take your body to be sold for money to buy cocaine. But you're not a bad. I'm worse, because I'm buying it from you. I'm buying your sex for money, helping you to buy drugs. I would like to do that. I want you to explain this to me, what happened." And she began to cry and tell me about her experience. All the guys in the neighborhood
stupid. You a dumb. That girl is a drug addict. Does she need love? Does she need help?
Yes.
Of course she does. I got help. I got help in many ways with many people. I still need help by you.
Yes, sir.
So I said, I took it to Calabas, to a restaurant. We were eating. And she started crying. Telling me about her experience with her uncle and this and that and the other. She said, you have any more money? I said, why? I want some money. I gave her $200. She disappeared. 5 years later, somebody came in my room about 6 o'clock in the evening in my house in Puerto Rico, San Juan. Dr. Sebi, I keep demanding, Ed is sending you a letter. His name is Coco. I opened the letter. A little picture fell out. A picture of a little baby. And the letter read, Dr. Sebi, before I die, you will be the last person in my eyes. You are the only person that had the heart to come and rescue me. I needed help, and you gave it to me. I came to New York. I went to school. I lived with my sister. I'm married. I have a little girl because of you. Now, how do you think of that? How do you think of that even when I'm telling you this right now? It resonates with me. And why can't we be there to help you,
buddy?
Yes, sir. Yeah, the little girl in our song. The little girl in our song that hangs around, the one that we call the Dr. Gal. But she needs our love just as much as we need hers. And we have to begin to practice that. But I found that that is accomplished when I joined Urua, when I became acquainted with Urua. Urua is so delicious, it's so good. Urua is the essence of black existence. It doesn't allow you to even think bad about anyone. It doesn't allow you to indicate an unreal about yourself. You know me? I used to have these funny things about my knees. I used to hate my knees. I thought my knees were ugly. And I met many people think that they're ugly. And there aren't any ugly people. How could you be ugly when you are unique? You are unique. I mean, when I look at you, I'm looking at the only one like you. So how could you be ugly? For you to be ugly, I gotta compare one like you, and that other one does not exist. You occupy a unique place in this community of humanity, of human beings. You are unique. We all are. In that uniqueness, how do you write a book that I'm gonna receive benefits from when I'm unique? The only way that I can communicate to you a message that will compliment you is not one that I designed, because the one that I live by, I didn't even design that one. Remember, I wanted to be a musician. I turned out to be a healer. And I was frightened when I saw it because I'm a merchant seaman. You know those merchant seamen are vulgar people? They travel to drink rum and go to whole houses all over the world. So I was afraid that there would be some residuals of that semen coming out of me. But over the years, the good Lord have helped me to maintain a certain discipline and a growth. I'm 79 years of age now. Sometimes I say, you know something, I've been cheated. I've been cheated. Because I'm 79 and I just begin to learn. Why did I learn this when I was 30? Good. Because that is not your original life. You're supposed to travel the journey. You're supposed to travel because the journey that I travel is mine and mine alone, like yours. Each and every one of us in this hall tonight have our own individual journey. And it is good. All we need to do is to support each other's. Hey man, How you doing? Well, I'm doing good. How are you? I'm doing fine too. That's good. I just talk about beautifying the community, building flowers and growing things in the community. Of course, you bring new life because it's love. To give that love, you have to love yourself, and that comes with the food. Uruwa teaches us that you don't criticize anyone because there are people that resonate with Christianity and they love to be Christians and they live very well, like my mother. Others say, well, I'm a Muslim and they like being a Muslim. And it's good because it resonates with you. Some are Buddhists, some are Hindus. They all are beautiful. What Uruwa does is to show that we occupy a different space. And in occupying that different space, there's a food that comes with it. A food that will ensure that your life will be maintained in that path that will maintain peace. The message is what? God. God is at the bottom of everything, sustaining. One day I gave a speech in Washington, and I don't know why I went there, but I did. It was the truth, and it's still the truth. I was told that God made everything, and that everything God made is good. Am I right here to tell you? Who made the devil? You see why Uruwa teaches us that we're not going to hate the devil and love God. We're going to love God and understand the devil. And you have just neutralized sin. There's no fear. Because God is your Savior. In fact, there was a dialogue with Satan and me. He wanted to know why I love him. I said, if God protects me, why should I be afraid of you? But you go tell that to Christians, he said. Because they always talk about me. But you're not afraid of me. I said, why should I be? Give me a reason why I should be afraid of you, Satan, when God already is my Savior. And I hope that I could live according to the dictates as much as I possibly can. I'm not going to stand before you tonight and tell you that I'm all that, because I'm not. I'm not saving the boy. The same little boy that was raised by Violet and Mama Hay. The same little boy that was obedient. But I learned the beauty of it. The beauty of obedience is that nobody could tell you anything that is negative because you are obedient. But to get there, you have to eat right. This is why we put together the compound like the Biento. The Biento? Well, I was very, very much bothered by the activity going on in the community in the 60s and 70s and 80s. The unrest, the violence. So we put together a compound in a Biento to bring the nerve, quiet the nerve down. So I didn't know what the compound would be like. I gave it to a Mexican girl named Guadalupe. Guadalupe, I said, I have to go to town, but I just made this compound, and I want you to try it. And when I came back an hour later, Guadalupe said, I feel like the wind. In Spanish, she said, me siento como el viento. I feel like the wind. That's where it got the title as Viento. When you take it, brothers and sisters, you're going to feel the difference immediately. You're going to love people that you once may have felt something against. I did it. You know, people does things to you, and you feel like you should do something bad. But no, the person that did something to us is sick. Is sick. I had a bad enough to put another name. People names. People took money and said you were dead. And all kinds of stuff. I have nothing I can do. I was put in jail for raping my daughter. could someone put this together? How could someone arrange this, that I raped my 5-year-old daughter? But I sit in jail, and everybody would ask me, what you gonna do? I'm not gonna do anything. I was put in jail in New York for raping a white woman in 1959. What you gonna do? I'm not gonna do anything. It came and left. You live that world. You live in that world that is truthful. You don't have to worry about the accusations. I was put in jail because I practiced this medicine. Practicing medicine without a license. They put the cuffs on me and tell me I was a fraud. You know, that's embarrassing because a black man stand up to the world and tell them, look, this is what we black people would do. We always would do it. God did not equip Chinese and white people and others alone. God equipped each and every one of us with the understanding to live the way that we were designed to live. I know, do you want to decide that on me? Well, yes, at your age. But what you gonna do? I'm not gonna hide it. We should be proud, especially us black people. Brother, cure the diseases. But we can be cured. We're doing something. Let us take a look at the whole picture. What is it that we produce that we could be proud of to say, well, we black folks produce this? Japanese says, we produce the best TV, the best car. German said we produce the best cameras. America said we produce the best planes. What we black folks say we produce. The best medicine. So we have something to offer the world.